It's absolutely amazing to have you here in the audience tonight. As much as we enjoyed live streaming last year, all the performers are delighted to have you here in the room with us. So please make lots of noise and encourage our amazing performers. So, basically, if you're attending your first soiree, what happens is I introduce all the acts over here. I tell you a bit about each performer, while the crew behind me seamlessly get the next act ready. I also tell a few terrible jokes, which have now become kind of legendary. And yes, Mr. Sinclair, that will be happening again. But mainly it's about celebrating the amazing and incredible talent we have here at Finborough School, from year 7 all the way through to year 13. So, let's get this soiree started with our first act. Opening the show tonight, we have year 13 student who's been a huge part of the Finborough Performing Arts family. After first appearing in Guys and Dolls, he's gone on to lead roles in School of Rock and The Addams Family. Tonight, we finally persuaded him to sing and play his guitar for us. Ladies and gentlemen, with slow dancing in a burning room, it's Tom Pryor!
Nice.
Storm before the calm. This is the deep and dying breath of this love that we've been working on. Can't seem to hold you like I want to, so I can feel you in my arms. Nobody's gonna come and save you. We pull too many false alarms. We're going down. You can see it too. We're going down, and you know that we're doomed. My dear, we are slow dancing in a burning room. Nothing to me. Maybe you're the only light I ever saw. I'll make the most of all my sadness. You'll be a bitch because you can. You try to hit me just to hurt me, so you leave me feeling dirty, but you can't understand. We're going down. You can see it too. We're going down. We're doomed, my dear, we're slow dancing in a burning room. So go and cry about it, why don't you? Go cry about it, why don't you? Go cry about it, why don't you? Go cry about it, why don't you? My dear, we are slow dancing in a burning room. My dear, slow dancing in a burning room. My dear, slow dancing in a burning room.
Thank you, Tom. What an amazing way to start tonight's show. That was just so lovely. You'd pay good money for that, wouldn't you? And you're here for free. So there you go. Tom is being followed by a very talented year 9 student, Amelia Clayton. Emilio's studying GCSE drama and music and just loves performing. She's chosen a song tonight from one of my favourite musicals, which is much discussed between me and my Year 11 students in what we call the Jeremy Jordan fan club. You know what I'm talking about. From the fantastic musical Bonnie and Clyde, singing Dying Ain't So Bad, it's Emilio!
Dying ain't so bad, not if you both go together. Only when one's left behind does it get sad. But a short and loving life, that ain't so bad. I only hope to God that I go first. I couldn't live on memories. I'm sorry, but I'm not that strong. There are some things in life you can't replace. Love like ours don't happen twice. When all his days are through, mine will be too. It's dying ain't so bad, not if you both go together. Only when one's left alone does it get sad. Short and loving life, that ain't so bad. I met boys who talk about farms and horses, but they don't do much for me. I don't need to end up in a rocking chair. Seems you got to live your life just once, if that's how it's gotta be. And I'd rather breathe in life than dusty air. Dying ain't so bad, not if you both go together. Only when one's left alone does it get sad. But a short and loving life, but a short and loving life, but a short and loving life, that ain't so bad.
Well done, Amelia, that was absolutely awesome. Next up is Tom Berkovich. Since joining the school, Tom has wowed us with his amazing dancing, athleticism, and incredible academic achievements. Next year, he's part of our school leadership team as head of house, and I know he'll do an incredible job inspiring our younger students. Tonight, he's playing our lovely grand piano, which many of us have fallen in love with already today, and showing us more of a wide range of his talents. Playing Maple Leaf Rag, it's Tom!
Thank you.
Brilliant, Tom, thank you. And again, we'll be seeing more of Tom later this evening. Next up, we have our first dramatic performance of the evening. A combination of our popular GCSE drama course and Lambda lessons has led to a pleasing rise in drama performances in this year's soiree. And first up is Victoria Oberhaw. Victoria has decided to perform her stunning monologue from her GCSE drama work, performing as Pip from Things I Know To Be True. Pip is the eldest daughter in a family who have a lot of problems, and this piece is certainly full of emotion. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Victoria.
Three children, a son and two daughters. To a woman who is good and fine and right and beautiful. But I don't care, because I feel loved by him like I've never felt loved by Steve, my good, sweet husband who's done nothing but care for me and the children, who does not look much further in life than the end of his own driveway. And now, I am waiting for his call. My lover, wondering if tonight he'll find the perfect excuse to leave his good wife, his sweet children, his safe home. And come to me. I didn't want to be this woman, Mum. But I can't leave, I won't. Because eventually, you will have to make a choice. And it probably won't be me. But for now, well, for now, I am this woman.
Wasn't that amazing characterisation and emotion there from Victoria? Well done there. We've also persuaded her to sing later in the show, so we'll be ready for that one as well. While we just quickly clear the stage, I'll tell you a little something about our very talented Mr. Griffin, who's playing the piano tonight. Round of applause for Mr. Griffin. Mr. Griffin was busy setting up these lovely lights for us, and he leaned the ladder up against the grand piano. "Stop!" I shouted. "What are you doing?" He said, "I need the ladder." I said, "Why?" He said, "I need to hit the high notes." There you go, there's number one. Okay. Next up, we have some of our youngest performers tonight. We have Bella Bridgman and Joey Hamilton from Year 7. These two have choreographed, with a little help from Ellie Schofield, their very own dance. And I think both of them should definitely be thinking about GCSE drama in the future. Dancing to Fight Song, we have Bella and Joey!
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove that I'm alright song. My power's turned up. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep, I say I'm in too deep. In too deep. It's been 2 years, I miss my home. There's a fire burning in my bones. Still believe, yeah, I still believe.
My fight song. Take back my
Great stuff, girls, that was brilliant. And great to see some of our Year 7s dancing so well already. That's amazing. A lot more dance to look forward to later as well. Next up, we have CJ from Year 11, who's loved being part of all of our music concerts, and it's great to see him sharing his talent with us tonight. CJ's performing the classic Bieber number, Love Yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, it's CJ!
For all the times that you rain on my parade, and all the clubs you get in using my name, you think you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well I ain't. And I didn't wanna write a song, 'cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby I'll be moving on. And I think you should be something I don't wanna hold back. Baby, you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. 'Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. All the times you told me that you hated my friends, the only problem was with you and not them. For every time you told me my opinion was wrong, try to make me forget where I came from. And I didn't want to write a song, 'cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, baby I'll be moving on. And I think you should be something I don't want to hold back. Baby you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. 'Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. No. For all the times that you made me feel small, we fell in love, now I feel nothing at all. I never felt so low when I was vulnerable. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls? 'Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself.
Brilliant, CJ. Well done. That was amazing. Next up, we have Amelia Croft from Year 7. You may have been lucky enough to last week see Amelia as Sebastian the Crab in our recent Little Mermaid production, where she really stood out with her characterization and comic timing. Tonight, we've taken the giant claws off her hands so that she could play the piano, and she's performing tonight Moonbeams. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Amelia Croft!
Thank you.
Thank you, Amelia. That was lovely. Well done. Next up, we have some more dance and a fantastic dance solo from Year 11 student Tallulah Hume. Tilly's a very talented individual who not only takes amazing photos, sings, dances, competed on the sports pitch, but has also recently been elected to our leadership team as head of house for next year. Tonight, she's performing a piece she choreographed herself for GCSE dance. Let's welcome to the stage, Tilly! Beautiful, Tilly. Well done. I'll let you get your breath back now. She's going to dance again later, so she needs to get her breath back. Next up, we have Livy Jackson in Year 10, who's studying GCSE dance and drama. I think Livy's been in just about every show that I've directed here since she was in Year 3. And if some of you have been around as long as I have, you might remember her as Artful Dodger in Oliver. Tonight, she's going to sing a stunning song by Lord Liability. It's Livy!
Mistake of dancing in my storm. Says it was poison, so I guess I'll go home into the arms of the girl that I love, the only love I haven't screwed up. She's so hard to please, but she's a forest fire. I do my best to meet her demands, play a romance, we slow dance in the living room, but all that a stranger would see is one girl swaying alone, stroking her cheek. They say, you're a little much for me. You're a liability. You're a little much for me. So they pull back, make other plans. I understand, I'm a liability. Get you wild, make you leave. I'm a little much for everyone. truth is, I am a toy that people enjoy till all of the tricks don't work anymore. And then they are bored of me. I know that it's exciting running through the night, but every perfect summer's eating me alive until you're gone.
Well done, Livy. What an amazing performance there. Well done. Now we have some more acting skills with two of our Year 8 girls who are both going to study GCSE drama next year, which is great. We have Phoebe Hume and Eoli Lloyd-Legendre, who both love being part of the Addams Family and can't wait for next year's show. In fact, they ask me all the time what we're going to do. Girls, you have to wait till prize giving. Performing a great duologue called The Mirror, it's Phoebe and Eoli.
Nothing exciting ever happens to me.
I look terrible.
You're telling me.
Hey!
Hey!
You're not me.
Thank goodness for that.
Get out of my mirror.
But I'm not in anything except my bedroom. You're the one who's in the mirror. Isn't it cramped?
Very funny. Listen, I've got a date tonight. And even though it's a boring old Arnold, I want to look good. So send me or whoever's meant to be in their back.
This is out of my hands, honest. It's never happened before. Are you sure you're not just a piece of glass?
Don't get insulting.
This is kind of interesting, you know. Not from my perspective.
I bet I know what's going on. You're my alter ego sent here to help me learn more about myself. That's it. Turn around.
What?
Turn around. I want to see what my other side looks like. Boy, am I in bad shape.
Hey!
Well, you could lose a few pounds.
How would you like to lose a few teeth?
Try it. How can you reach me?
Fine. You're right. So, what are we going to do? Just stand here and insult each other?
No. That would be a waste of a valuable opportunity. This thing, whatever's going on, might not last very long. We'd better make good use of the time.
Maybe if we went to bed and we're up tomorrow.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, yes. But I don't see much good coming of this.
Don't you? By exploring our opposites, we can learn more about ourselves.
Who cares?
I'm already learning something.
Like what?
Like I'm inquisitive, and you're not. Say, are you going on a date too tonight?
Forget it. I'd rather go horseback riding.
You're kidding.
No, the horse doesn't talk back.
That's true. But then again, I don't have to worry about Arnold kicking me in the head. And I don't have to feed him every day.
Okay, we both have reason for keeping the company we do. So what?
Do you like to go dancing?
No. Bowling?
Do you like long dresses?
No. Jeans?
What's your favourite band?
The Plastic Slugs.
Favourite colour?
Blue.
What? Blue? But that's mine too. So that means, even though we're different, we're not complete opposites. Let's try to keep going, please.
Okay.
Terrific. Favourite season?
Spring.
Mine too. Favourite flower?
Tulip.
Yes, favourite time of the day.
Morning.
This is wonderful. Favourite smell?
Baking bread.
Favourite sound?
Bird singing.
Favourite food?
Stewed tomatoes. You have a problem with stewed tomatoes?
I'm sorry. I was just expecting something more along the lines of ice cream or cake. You know, you're actually getting along a lot better than I thought we would.
I'm sorry if I snapped you earlier. This has been kind of fun.
It's okay. I think this whole mirror deal was all to throw us.
Yeah, the mirror. I forgot you're not over here. I almost wish you could be. With me, that is.
No, no, it would never work out.
I'm going now.
Wait, going where?
Out of my room, so I don't have to go meet you. The mirror.
Wait, wait, don't go.
Okay.
Shake. Let's just wave at each other.
I wonder when Girl Mirror's back.
I don't know. You know this could be permanent.
Permanent? I like a little privacy in my bedroom. Not that I have weird habits. Hey, you're getting fuzzy.
We could see how we grow up and change.
Listen, listen to me. You're fading away, I can hardly hear you.
Me, a successful scientist. You, a famous show jumper.
Hello? Hello? She's gone.
She's gone.
Bye.
Well done, girls, that was awesome. Next up, we have another duo. It's Maisie Barrett in year 12 and Lily Freeborn Morgan in year 11. Or should I say, Morticia and Alice from this year's senior school show, The Addams Family. Both these girls absolutely smashed it in their lead roles with incredible solo vocals and brilliant acting. Now, it's no secret amongst the students that I'm not the biggest fan of ABBA. And however much they ask for Mamma Mia, it's not happening. But I have been won over by this rendition of ABBA's Slipping Through My Fingers. It's Maisie and Lily!
Bag in hand, she leaves home in the early morning, waving goodbye with an absent-minded smile. I watch her go with a surge of that well-known sadness, and I have to sit down for a while. The feeling that I'm losing her forever without really entering. Laughter, that funny little girl. Slipping through my fingers all the time, I try to catch her every minute. The feeling in it, slipping through my fingers all the time. My vivid schemas in my mind, each time I think I'm close to knowing. She keeps on growing. I wish that I could three.
Well done, girls. That was amazing. Maisie, could you just hang on for a second, please? Just come back up here. I've got a little surprise for Maisie. We're just going to have a little bit of fun. Maisie, come back up. I've got a very special award for Maisie that she knows nothing about. Now, Maisie's been in every show that I've done, and it's great to see her growing in confidence over the years. Perhaps she might be a little bit too confident, because in one of our performing arts lessons, she not only drank my hot chocolate, but then proceeded to tell me the order of this year's soiree. So, I've got a special award for Maisie this year, the Diva of the Year Award. Next up, we have a trio of students from our Year 9 GCSE Drama Group. As part of their course, they had to study and act out parts of the amazing play Blood Brothers by Willie Russell. Ella Sherfield, Emma Smith and Alice Prentice have decided to act out the part of the play when the main characters, Mickey, Eddie and Sammy, are only 7 years old. So performing their GCSE Blood Brothers piece, it's Ella, Emma and Alice!
Do you want to come and play?
I might do, but not playing now because I'm pissed off.
Pissed off? You say the most smashing things. Do you know any more words like that?
Yeah. I know loads of words like that. You know, the F word.
Pardon?
The F word.
What does it mean?
I don't know, but it sounds good though, doesn't it?
Fantastic. When I get home, I'm going to look up in a dictionary.
In the what?
Dictionary. You do know what a dictionary is, don't you?
Of course I do. It's the thingy, isn't it?
The book that explains the meanings of the words.
The meaning of words, yeah. Our Sammy will be home soon. I hope he's in a good mood. He can be dead mean sometimes.
Why?
It's because he's got a plate in his head.
A plate? In his head?
Yeah. When he was little, my mum was at work and our Donna Marie was meant to be looking after him. But he fell out of the window and he broke his head. So they took him to hospital.
Put a plate in his head. A plate? So like a dinner plate?
I don't think so, because our Sammy's head isn't really that big. It must be one of those little plates you have a bread off.
A side plate?
No, it's on top.
And can you see the shape of it? In his head?
I suppose. I suppose if you look under his hair.
You know the most smashing things? Do you want to be my best friend?
Yeah, if you want.
What's your name?
Michael Johnson, but everyone calls me Mickey.
Edward Lyons.
Do they call you Eddie?
No.
Well, I will.
Will you really?
Yeah. How old are you, Eddie?
7.
I'm older than you. I'm nearly 8.
Well, I'm nearly 8, really.
What's your birthday?
18th of July.
So's mine.
Really? Hey, we were born the same day.
Will you be blood brothers? Do you want to be my blood brother, Eddie?
Yes, please.
It hurts, you know. Give us yours. This means that we're blood brothers and we'll always stand by each other. Now, say after me. I will always defend my brother.
I will always defend my brother.
And stand by him.
And stand by him.
And share.
Bang!
Sammy! Give us a sweet. I haven't got any.
Yes, you do. I gave you one for your Sammy earlier. Remember?
Little Robin Git. No, I'm not. And anyway, you pinch me, best gone. It's the last anyway. It only fires caps. I'm going to get a real gun soon. I'm going to get an air gun. Bang! Bang! What are you looking at?
Pardon?
That's Eddie. He lives up by the park. He's a friggin' poshie. No, he's not. He's my best friend. Oh, you're just soft. You're just soft little kids. Anyway, where are you going?
I'm off to do another burial. My worms have died again.
Are you coming? Are you coming? Our Sammy's doing a burial. Can we come?
Look, they was alive and wriggling this morning, but by dinner time, they were dead.
That was amazing, girls. What I love about that performance is, not for one second do you not think they're 7-year-old boys. That's how good their acting is. Brilliant. Now we have another Year 9 student who's studying dance, drama, and music, a real triple threat. Holly Sinclair. Holly played Belle in Beauty and the Beast and loves being involved in performing arts. She's been practicing and honing her skills in our music concert, and delighted she's singing such a beautiful song about acceptance and love, till forever falls apart. Put your hands together for Holly!
Out on her own, dreaming in a world that we both know it's out of our control. But if stuff hits the fan, we're not alone, 'cause you've got me and you know that I've got you and I know. If the tide takes California, I'm so glad I got to know ya. And if the sky falls from heaven above, oh, I know I had the best time falling into love. We've been living on a fold line, and for a while you were all mine. I spent a lifetime giving you my heart. I swear that I'll be yours forever till forever falls apart. Till forever falls apart. So this is it, that's how it ends. I guess there's nothing more romantic than dying with your friends. And I'm not sorry for myself. I wouldn't want to spend a minute loving anybody else, 'cause you've got me and you know that I've got you and I know. If the tide takes California, I'm so glad I got to hold ya. And if the sky falls from heaven above, oh, I know I had the best time falling into love. We've been living on a fold line, and for a while you were all mine. I spent a lifetime giving you my heart. I swear that I'll be yours forever till forever falls apart. Till forever falls apart. We never had it from the start. Till death do us part. If the tide takes California, I'm so glad I got to hold ya. And if the sky falls from heaven above, oh, I know I had the best time falling into love. We've been living on a fold line, and for a while you were all mine. I spent a lifetime giving you my heart. I swear that I'll be yours forever till forever falls apart.
Thanks, Holly, that was amazing. Great song choice and lovely performance. Next up, we have two performers from Year 8 who both love dancing and singing too. It's Olive Gregory and Phoebe Hume. Tonight, they're singing a song from the brilliant musical Matilda, written by the talented Tim Minchin. With Naughty, it's Olive and Phoebe!
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. So they say, the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. Innocent victims of their story. Like Romeo and Juliet, 'twas written in the stars before they even met. That love and faith and a touch of stupidity would rob them of the hope of living happily. The endings are often a little bit gory. I wonder why they didn't just change their story. We're told we have to do what we're told, but surely sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let it get on top you, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. Cinderella in the cellar didn't have to do much as far as I could tell. Her godmother was two-thirds fairy. Suddenly her lot was a lot less scary. But what if you haven't got a fairy to fix it? Sometimes you have to make a little bit of mischief. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, not change a thing. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let it get on top you, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. In a slip of a vote, there's a tiny revolt. In the seat of a war, in a creak of a floorboard, the store put a ripkin with a flap of a wing. The tiniest might pack, the mightiest sing. Every day starts with a tick of a clock. All escapes starts with a click of a lock. If you're stuck in your story and want to get out, you don't have to cry, you don't have to shout. Cause if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let it get on top you, won't change a thing. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let it get on top you, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. And nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
Great job, girls, that was amazing. Now it's time for a little bit more drama from Sam Berkovich in year 11. Sam's been studying Lambda for quite a few years and has done some fantastic soiree performances over the years, as well as his leading role as Mao in the Addams Family. Sam's chosen an extract from Shakespeare's Two Gentlemen of Verona, and he does it brilliantly. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Sam.
Nay, to be this hour ere I have done weeping. All the kind of launches have this very fault. I have received my proportion, like the prodigious sun, and am going with some produce to the imperial's court. Oh.
I think Crab, my dog, be the sourest natured dog that lives. My mother weeping, my father wailing, my sister crying, our maid howling, and our cat wringing her hands. And all the house in a great perplexity, yet did not this cruel-hearted cur shed one tear. He is a stone, a very pebble stone, and hath no more pity in him than a dog. Why, my grandam, having no eyes, look you, wept herself blind at my parting. Nay, I'll show you the manner of it. This shoe is my father. No, this left shoe is my father. No, this left shoe is my mother. Nay, that cannot be so neither. Oh, it is so, it is so. It hath the worse of soul. This shoe, with the hole in it, is my mother. A and this is my father, a vengeance aunt. Now, there it is. Sit. Right. This is my sister, and I am the dog. Oh, no. The dog is me, and I am the dog. No. The dog is himself, and I am the dog. So, now come I to my father.
Father, your blessing. Now should not the shoe speak a word for weeping? Well, should I kiss my father?
Well, he weeps on.
Now come I to my mother. Oh, that she could speak now like a wood woman. Well, I kiss her. Why, there it is. There's my mother's breath up and down. Now come I to my sister. Mark the moan she makes. But the dog all this while sheds not a tear nor speaks a word. But see how I lay the dust with my tears.
That was brilliant, Sam. Thank you. That was amazing. It's time to get Victoria back to the stage. We first heard Victoria sing Amazing Grace as Tamika in School of Rock. And since then, she's wowed us at prize giving and other musical concerts. She's promised me she'll be back for next year's show. So singing Traitor is Victoria.
Brown guilty eyes and little white lies. You played dumb, but I always knew that you talked to her, maybe did even worse. Kept quiet so I could keep you. Ain't it funny how you ran to her the second that we called it quits? Ain't it funny how you said you were friends? Now it sure as hell don't look like it. You betrayed me, and I know that you'll never feel sorry for the way you hurt, yeah. You talked to her when we were together, loved you at your worst, but that didn't matter. It took you 2 weeks to go off and date her. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor. Now you bring her around just to shut me down. Show her off like she's a new trophy. And I don't know if you were true. There's no damn way that you could fall in love with somebody that quickly. Ain't it funny? All the twisted games, all the questions you used to avoid. Ain't it funny? Remember I brought her up and you told me I was paranoid. You betrayed me, and I know that you'll never feel sorry for the way you hurt, yeah. You talked to her when we were together, loved you at your worst, but that didn't matter. It took you 2 weeks to go off and date her. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor. God, I wish that you had thought this through before I went and fell in love with you. When she's sleeping in the bed being made, don't you dare forget about the way you betrayed me. And I know that you'll never feel sorry
for the way her, yeah. You talked to her when we were together. Loved you at your worst, but that didn't matter. It took you 2 weeks to go off and date her. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor. Yeah, you're still a traitor. God, I wish that you had thought this through before I went and fell in love with you.
That was amazing, Victoria. Well done. Okay, time to close our first half, and what a way we've got to close it. Performing now, we have 6 Year 11 girls who all studied GCSE dance this year. We've got Mabel, Ellie, Tilly, Esme, Lily and Lara doing Feeling Good by Michael Bublé. This was all choreographed by themselves, and I've seen firsthand how hard they've worked, making Miss McMillan and me as their lead teacher very proud. Let's raise the roof for the final act of part one. It's Mabel, Ellie, Tilly, Esme, Esme, Lily and Lara.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on a tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me. Of the pine, you know how I feel. Oh, freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. feels so good.
Thank you so much. That was an amazing first half. I hope you all enjoyed that. We've got lots more to look forward to in part two. Just before we start part two, I wanted to say what an amazing year we've managed to have in Finborough Performing Arts. Even with the COVID world out there, we've just done such an amazing job this year. If many of you wouldn't have known, we got the Adams family in just before lockdown in November. All the kids had such an amazing time performing that. We performed another major prep school production last week, The Little Mermaid, and we even managed to have audiences for that. We've done Festive Finborough, we've done Finborough Sessions, we've done so much, and obviously having you here tonight is the icing on the cake. So, yeah, in a time of difficulty, I'd like to thank Mr. Clark, Mr. Sinclair, and Mrs. Sinclair for just always having such a can-do attitude. So let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. And let's get on with part two. So, starting off part two for us, we have the brilliant Eoli. Eoli from year eight is going to sing with a very small backing band. She burst onto the scene in School of Rock and has performed in all of our shows and concerts since. Singing a gorgeous song by Arlo, ladies and gentlemen, it's Eoli!
Millie tried to talk the pleasure back into being alive, reminiscing about the apricots and blunts on peg and rye. Won't call her friends, cause she's ashamed of being locked into bed. Can't feel her legs, and feeling like a liar at best. You're not alone, like you think you are. You're not alone, like you think you are. We all have scars, I know it's hard. You're not alone, you're not alone. You're not alone, like you think you are. You're not alone, you're not alone. Started sweating bullets when her dad asked, how'd you really feel? She said, I've been feeling like something inside me wants to scream. Won't call my friends, I'm persuaded that they'll leave in the end. Can't feel my legs, I'm feeling like a liar at best. You're not alone, like you think you are. You're not alone, like you think you are. We all have scars, I know it's hard. You're not alone, you're not alone. You're not alone, like you think you are. You're not alone, like you think you are. We all have scars, I know it's hard. You're not alone, you're not alone.
Thank you, Eoli, that was lovely. Yeah, Mr. Griffin was not actually playing the smallest drum kit in the world there, or a children's drum kit. That is called a jazz kit, he'd like everyone to know. Okay, so we're going to change the tone again and have some more drama and change up the mood a bit, because we now have Emma Smith from Year 9 who's going to perform her Things I Know To Be True monologue, which I absolutely loved in drama lessons. I'm sure you're going to love now. Acting as Pip, it's Emma.
Hello.
Vancouver. They're like home living. That's a reference to Lenny Cohen's song, except he was talking about New York. You know that, don't you? Famous Boo Raincoat used to play it. Over and over. Four in the morning, the end of December. Writing to you just to see if you're better. New York is cold, but I like where I'm living. There's music on Clinton Street all for the evening. I was on Skype to Katie the other day and found myself thinking she was a little plump. And wishing that her face wasn't quite so round and that her head didn't fall quite so straight from her head. Is this what we do to our daughters? Praise them while we secretly think they're not good enough. The first sign of development is this when we start to think they're not pretty enough or smart enough. I'm gonna be someone or find someone. Is this what we do? Maybe it's better that some daughters are raised by their fathers. We look at them and see the best. That's what Dad sees when he looks at me. I just wish you could too. And then Jane came by. With a lock of your hair, she said that you gave it to her on the night that you planned to go clear. Never really understood that song when I was a girl. I still don't, but I knew enough to know that it was about love. And every time you played it, you wanted to cry. Never did, of course, not with us around. Only once did I see you let yourself go. You thought you were alone in the back garden, leaning against the old gum tree, howling and howling and bashing your head against the trunk. Why were you crying that day, Mum? Sorry I never asked you. Why didn't we have those conversations? I guess we were too busy hiding from each other. The things that really mattered. And so I'm sitting here in my apartment in Vancouver and it's threatening to snow. And I hope that it does because that's a good enough excuse not to go out. And I'm listening to that song and wondering why it meant so much to you. And I can only ask this from a distance because I'm scared of seeing the truth in your face like you saw it in mine. I met him at an education conference here in Vancouver on that first trip. I didn't see it coming. But do you ever really see it coming? So yes, Mum, your accusation of another man was right. But are you ever wrong, Mum?
Well done, Emma. What a lovely, moving and emotional performance. Next up, we have Yasmin Bridgman, another Year 9 GCSE drama student, who played Lumiere in Beauty and the Beast in Year 6 and Angelica Adams in The Addams Family in Year 9. She had a lot of fun torturing teddy bears and generally being very evil. I promise she's not like that at home. Well, most of the time. Singing Take a Bow from Rihanna, it's Yasmin!
Yeah.
so dumb right now. Standing outside my house, trying to apologize. You're so ugly when you cry. Please just cut it out. And don't tell me you're sorry, 'cause you're not. And baby, when I know you're only sorry you got caught. But you put on quite a show, really had me going. Now it's time to go, curtains finally closing. That was quite a show, very entertaining. But it's over now. Go on and take a bow and grab your clothes and get gone. You better hurry up before the sprinkles come on. Talking about girl, I love you, you're the one. This just looks like a rerun. Please, what else is on? And don't tell me you're sorry, 'cause you're not. And baby, when I know you're only sorry you got caught. But you put on quite a show, really had me going. Now it's time to go, curtains finally closing. That was quite a show, very entertaining. But it's over now. Go on and take a bow. Oh, and the award for the best liar goes to you for making me believe that you could be faithful to me. Let's hear your speech out. How about a round of applause? A standing ovation. But you put on quite a show, but it's over now.
Well done, Yasmin, that was amazing, well done. We now welcome back to the stage the Berkovich brothers. This time, they're together. Both of these boys have such a huge range of talents. Tom is going to be playing the guitar and singing, while Sam accompanies on the piano. They're performing a brilliant song by the legendary Beatles called While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Please give it up for Tom and for Sam.
I look as you walk, see the lover that's sleeping, while my guitar gently weeps. I look at the floor and I see it needs sweeping, still my guitar gently weeps. Control you, they bought and sold. turning, while my guitar gently weeps. With every mistake, we must surely be learning, while my guitar gently weeps.
That was brilliant, boys. Well done. They're not quite finished yet. They'll be back later, but they can have a little rest. Following for the Beatles, we now have Finborough's very own power couple. Our own John and Yoko, you might say. No, actually, they're better than that. These two were simply phenomenal as Gomez and Morticia in the Addams Family. And actually, more than that, these two inspire the younger pupils at Finborough with their talent and their encouragement for the next generation. With a classic rendition of Love is an Open Door from Frozen, it's Maisie and Tom!
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face, and then suddenly I bumped into you.
I was thinking the same thing, cause like,
I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. Maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you,
I have found
I
my
see
place.
Your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. With you.
With you.
With you.
With you.
Love is an open door.
I mean, it's crazy.
What?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me.
Jinx again.
Our mental synchronization can't have the one explanation.
You
and I
were just meant to be. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye to the pain of the past. We don't have to feel it.
Hey, can I say something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier? Yes.
Thank you, guys. That was absolutely awesome. No, it wasn't real. Wasn't real. No. It's called acting. It's fine. I think. Okay. Next up, guys, we have Ariana. Now, Ariana's given me probably one of my most jaw-dropping moments of this school year. Ariana joined us in year 10, and I told her about the soiree, and she said, yeah, I'll audition, I'll do a little act. So knowing she did GCSE drama, I was expecting a monologue. So I sat there with my notebook, ready to take notes, and then she did this. And that is all I'm gonna say. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare for Ariana.
I tried hard to make you want me, but we're not supposed to be. And the truth will always haunt me, even though it set me free. And my tears flow like the ocean as they floated in the breeze. They were falling in slow motion, and they brought me to my knees. Oh, you're haunting me, taunting me, all in my brain. Turn out the light and now all up the maze. Fills me with doubt and I'm shouting your name out loud. Why do you want to put me through the pain?
Imagine my jaws. I was not expecting that. That was amazing, Ariana. Great job. Okay, moving on to the next one. Wow. Let's get our breath back and welcome to the stage Isabel Impett from Year 10. Izzy really stepped up when she auditioned for the lead role of Wednesday in The Addams Family and got it and did just an amazing performance. Her acting and singing really capturing Wednesday's slightly psychotic side, especially when she was shooting an arrow at her boyfriend Lucas with a blindfold. Tonight, she's singing Your Power by Billie Eilish. It's Izzy!
How dare you? And how could you?
was my fault. You were the devil, lost your appeal. Does it keep you in control for you to keep her in a cage? And you swear you didn't know. You said she thought she was your age. How dare you? Turns out that they kill your contract. Would you try not to abuse your power? I know we didn't choose to change. We might not want to lose your power.
Thank you, Izzy. That was fantastic. Well done. Let's have some more drama from our Year 9 GCSE students. And it's Amelia's turn, Amelia Clayton. We heard her singing earlier, and now she's performing a piece from The Brilliant Shakers by John Godpa, in which one of the characters goes to an audition. And unfortunately, this character is not as good an actress as Amelia is. Performing as Nikki from Shakers, it's Amelia!
Right, so I've read a piece. Yeah, but it's not from a play. Something I made myself. Yeah, and I've written it down on a piece of paper, so you can test me. Yeah, it's called Smile. Yeah. Right, I'll start, shall I? Yeah, all right. Oh, I'm a bit nervous, or might be a little bit rubbish. She's been in hospital for about 4 days. She was 70. She went in hospital for an hysterectomy. The operation had been a great success. Yeah, I went to see her. She even showed me the stitches. So I was at work, you know, having a good laugh and a good time. And then they rang the hospital. Said she'd had a stroke. So I went on the bus and I felt sick. Travelling all that way on the bus. She was on the sixth floor. Remember that? Yeah, in a cubicle full of old ladies. I walked in. My mum and dad were there. They were looking across the parking lot of the hospital. My auntie and uncle were there. They were crying. The ground was laid in bed. She tried to smile. I remember crying in the background. She looked at me, tried to speak. I said nothing. Face, blue, deformed. My mouth was just simple. I was close. Hello, Gran. I said, what's all this bloody nonsense about with a stroke, eh? She smiled at me. She smiled.
That was amazing, Amelia. Lovely range of emotion there, just insane. You can see why we love starting drama in Year 9, not in Year 10 as well, so which is great. Next up, we have the grand piano taking centre stage again, and playing this time is Florence Clark from Year 7. Florence absolutely wowed audiences last week with her delightfully evil Ursula in The Little Mermaid. In fact, with hair, makeup, costume, and stunning characterisation, Mr. Clark didn't even recognise his own daughter. Playing Primavera on our lovely piano, it's Florence! Amazing. Well done, Florence. Okay, next up we have another fantastic double act. It's CJ from Year 11 and Holly from Year 9. These two have both rocked it at Festive Finborough and Finborough sessions, and they're both always singing and practicing in the music rooms. They have a fantastic song for you tonight, which was featured in a recent Netflix film. We'll get the mics right this time. And with moral of the story is CJ and Holly.
So I never really knew you, God, I really tried to. Blindsided, addicted, for we could really do this, but really I was foolish. Hindsight, it's obvious. Talking with my lawyer, she said, where'd you find this guy? I said, some people fall in love with the wrong people sometimes. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. You can think that you're in love when you're really just in pain. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. In the end, it's better for me. That's the moral of the story, babe. Oh, 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 oh.
Memory turns into a bad dream, and running wild turns volatile. It's not funny how it changes, ended up like strangers, and we burned down our paper house. Talking with your father, he said that you could be mine. Said young people fall in love with the wrong people sometimes. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. You can think that you're in love when you're really just in pain. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. In the end, it's better for me. That's the moral of the story, babe. Oh ho,
oh ho, oh ho.
Say it's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all. That could be a load of, but I just need to tell you all.
Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. You can think that you're in love when you're really just engaged.
Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. In the end, it's better for me, that's the moral of the story. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. You can think that you're in love when you're really just in pain. Some mistakes get made, that's alright, that's okay. In the end, it's better for me, that's the moral of the story.
That was amazing, guys. Thank you so much. Everybody, we're going to have to break it very gently to Mr. Griffin's girlfriend that he's fallen in love with the piano. He's even considered chaining himself to it when it gets collected next week. Now the boys are back for the last time. It's Sam and Tom. This time they're switching over, and Tom is going to be playing the piano, and Sam is going to play his clarinet. With a lovely piece, we have Sam and Tom. Okay, brilliant, boys. Well done. Now you can actually relax. You are finally done. Well done, boys. Great stuff. So, as we get closer to the end of part two, let's have our final dance of the evening. Last year, Lara lit up the stage in a very sassy solo dance to Amy Winehouse. This year, she's sharing with us her solo dance in GCSE, which is just as stunning. And if Miss McMillan hasn't cried yet, we'll get her soon. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, Lara! Thank you, Lara, that was awesome. Amazing, well done. Okay, next up, we have none other than Summer from School of Rock. Wednesday from the Adams family. It's Liv Newcomb. Liv is performing a song from the brilliant musical Waitress, and when I say performing, I mean exactly that. Liv doesn't just sing, she really becomes the character. Jenna, who works as a waitress making pies, but dreams of a better life. With She Used to Be Mine, it's Liv!
Used to be mine.
back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you, and you're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew, who was reckless just enough. Gets hurt, she learns how to toughen up when she
Amazing, Liv. That was amazing. Thank you so much. Okay, here comes jaw-dropping moment number two from this year. So, Rasheen Hayward in year 11 had been studying drama with me since year 10. And I was really pleased with all her drama performances. And I just was loving watching her confidence grow and grow. And then suddenly, she sang. Tonight, she's going to be performing a monologue she wrote herself, a song she composed herself for her GCSE drama course. Her character's basically telling us about a very difficult time when they were bullied and how they coped and beat their bullies. With fairies, we have Rasheen!
Hearing whispering is no new thing to me. I remember coming into school on non-school uniform day, excited to show off my Tinkerbell dress. But as soon as I walked through those doors, all eyes were turned to me. All the boys tried to hide the laughter on their faces, and all the girls gave me criticizing looks. They all gossiped amongst each other. There was one girl who really despised me, Alana. She mocked me for liking fairies and how I wanted to be one. It even got to the point where I was harming and starving myself, because I was so hurt inside. I hated being in her presence. But I had to get away from all those whispers, to fly away like Tinkerbell would have done. So all of the gossip and all of the whispering flew away on the edge of a tune, a note, a melody. Why is it so hard to fit in? I'm just as a misfit, I just like different things, but you will ever understand. I hope you know you broke me. Feeling self-conscious for days, feeling upset, that's not okay. Friends, will you discern me?
Sometimes I wish I could be like you, but then I realize I'm different. I just wanted you to know you've broken my wings. I can no longer fly away. I just wanted to be friends, but it didn't work out. So now I'm gonna be left with my fairies, my broken wings.
Amazing, Machine. Well done. Now you've done it to a bigger audience, there's no stopping you now. Great stuff. Okay, guys, three to go. And next up, we have Lily Freeborn Morgan. Now, Lily was in my form in year 5, in year 7, in year 8, in year 9, in year 10, and year 11. And we've all been blown away by her singing performances over the years. It was great to see her in her lead role in the Addams Family, even though she loved the colour yellow. I asked Lily especially to sing this song tonight, as it's one of my absolute favourites. And it suits her voice so beautifully. With Think of Me from the Phantom of the Opera, it's Lily!
Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Imagine me once in a while, please promise me you'll try. When you find that once again you long to take your heart back and be free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me.
Wow, Lily, thank you. That was so, so stunning. Okay, guys, for the last two performances, we hand over to our year 13s. Our penultimate act is Alicia Shokobishi. Alicia has been studying performing arts with us for the last 2 years and loved being the genie in Aladdin, designing her own music program, and helping out backstage, front of house with our school productions. This girl is a demon with a clipboard. In fact, Mr. Haycock tried to take over her job with front of house last week, and that definitely didn't happen. Singing Running for us tonight, it's Alicia!
These four lonely walls have changed the way I feel. The way I feel. I stand still. And nothing else matters now, you're not here. So where are you? I've been calling you. I'm missing you. Where else can I go? Where else can I go? Chasing you, chasing you. Memories turn to dust. Please don't bury us. I've got you. I've got you. Chase, they're standing still. I'm running still. I'm running still. And every voice that cried inside my head forever drives. Forever drives. I've killed. Myself, I lose it all. If I lose myself, I lose it all.
Thank you, Alicia. That was amazing. Even though she's leaving us to go ahead into a bright future, we'll be seeing lots of Alicia, especially for all those who know Alicia, on TikTok, which she actually has been known to TikTok from an ambulance. Okay, up time, guys, for the final act. It's Tom Pryor. I'm genuinely worried about how we're going to replace him. Who else could have rocked the house as Dewey in School of Rock? Who else could have charmed the pants off us as Gomez in the Addams Family? His legendary ad-libbing gave me a few heart palpitations and actually added about 15 minutes to the show. Closing our show tonight with his amazing vocals and, of course, his legendary comic timing, as Donkey from Shrek. Don't let me go. It's Tom!
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together. No, 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 don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes, stop with the moping. You need a pal. And my calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back, wah, 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 when it gets scary. And I'll shave it when it gets hairy. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. And never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Like butter and grits, like kibbles and bits, like yin and yang, sturmer chang, ching a chang, attached at the hip, but not an old lady hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey, we'll stick together like that Velcro stuff. I'll be the fuzzy side, you can be the spiky. You know, kids' pajamas with the funny things at the bottom. You know the ones, feeties and donuts. What goes with donuts? Donuts and diabetes. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Hold me, hug me, take me, please. Na 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 na. Please don't let me go. I need you. 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 Don't let me. Go, go, don't let me go, 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 go.
Come to the end of another performing arts soiree, but just before we finish the night, we have some very exciting news. Miss McMillan, would you like to come up and join me? Okay. So, next year, we've decided to do two big major shows. And we're going to tell you what they are tonight. Okay, so, the first show is going to be from year 3 to year 10. And that show is, Miss McMillan?
Shrek!
Okay, cool. And also, we're doing our first ever year 11, 12, and 13 show only. And for that, Miss McMillan's going to give you a little clue.
Better get it.
It's Legally Blonde! Thank you so much, everyone. Lots to look forward to next year. Just before we go, Ollie, 2 seconds. I just want to say a few quick thank yous. Behind the scenes today, there's been a huge team of people working. Can we just say a big round of applause for Phil and Ant at the back there? for all the catering team. Thank you, catering team. For Elijah, who's been doing all the stage. For Mrs. Lyons, who's sadly not here tonight, but has done so much work. Thank you, Mrs. Lyons. Miss McMillan. And Mr. Griffin. That was the Soiree 2021. Thank you, good night.
And Mr. Bridgman.